sometime you got to see.
Broadcasting from the PLA Situation Room in Roy, New Mexico, you're listening to The Snowplow Show.
Now it's time.
On Prank Call Nation.
Cactus.
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 Cactus. I am playing games.
Cactus.
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 Am I supposed to be doing
this? Cactus.
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 Cactus. This cocksucker.
Cactus.
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 You've got to be crap on my ball.
Cactus.
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 It's gonna be a fuck job to edit.
Cactus.
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 You're calling me a hobo.
Cactus.
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 Cactus. Roy the retarded boy.
Cactus.
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 How about if I come down and punch your head off?
Cactus.
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 Cactus. You blowing smoke up my ass.
Cactus.
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 You think a tracer can stop me?
Hello, everyone. This is Roy, and you're listening to the Snowplow Show. Today is Monday, November 3rd, 2014. What the hell? Daylight savings was this weekend. That's what my computer is telling me as I'm looking at the date. I didn't even know that. I bet you half the clocks in my house are wrong. I had no idea. I thought it seemed early. God, I'm stupid. This episode is sponsored by Michael, who is not a Patreon person or a subscriber or anything, as far as I know. But a while back, I think before summer even, he sent me $50. To buy a USB sound card so that I could take calls on the air whenever I did a live show. This is not a live show, by the way. This is pre-recorded, like most of the shows are. So don't whine at me because you missed the live show because there wasn't one. Anyway, I never bought a sound card with his $50. I blew it on hookers and beer. No, really. I put his money, I think it might have been a Amazon gift card that he sent me $50 of. And I put that toward a Cisco phone, an IP phone to sit on my desk. Because I thought I could patch that into the show in the same way that I would do the USB sound card. So far, I haven't even tried to do that, but I think I can do that. Nobody knows what the hell I'm talking about. This IP phone is awesome, though. It has four lines on it, and each line is a different spoofing number. Like, if I push line 2, and I call out on line 2, anyone looking at their caller ID display will see that I'm calling from a payphone at the Portland airport. Another line on the phone is the rejection hotline in New York City. And then there's one that's my actual home phone number. I have to try and not call people with that. That always sucks. But yeah, thanks, Michael, for sending me that $50, which I didn't use for its intended purpose. Mostly because of Mistress Morgan, because she actually bought me a USB sound card and had it sent to me. And it works. I can put people in the show now. But there's this really weird grounding issue that makes this high-pitched noise. You guys might have noticed it on the show that I did with Neon. Bugs the shit out of me. Everyone else says they can't hear it, but I gotta get that figured out. Some kind of interference between the two sound cards. I'm gonna work on that this week, so I can start taking callers again. Because I miss being an asshole to the people that call in and hanging up on them. I am gonna hook the Cisco IP phone into the whole soundboard thing here for the show, so I can take calls through that too, because that'd be kinda neat. Since it's November, we're that much closer to Pranksgiving, the show that happens every Thanksgiving night and lasts for 24 hours. That should be a fun time. It was last year. I think I did 4 hours with Roxy, and I still haven't gotten that goddamn video that she made inside Walmart while I pranked people in there. Damn her. Hopefully, though, we'll get some details about Pranksgiving on prankcallnation.com soon. We really need to set up a page for that. prankcallnation.com/pranksgiving. That's where I predict the page will be that we will make about Pranksgiving, and let you listen to archives of past Pranksgivings. But for now, it's a 404. If you go there and it's a 404 a month from now, please yell at somebody. Just any random person will do. There's a thing I've been wanting to do with phone calls, and I need to do it this week. So I think I'm gonna do it on this show. Maybe I'll do it on other shows this week too. But elections are coming up, and at some point in the past, I said that, or I think this was a suggestion by somebody. They said, I need to tell landlords that I'm renting out their lawn space or their roof space or whatever for election signs. And candidates for elections are paying me money to put, you know, signs up on their property. I think somebody suggested that. I don't think I came up with that. But I think I did come up with the, I wanted to put vinyl signs up on the roofs. You know, instead of just signs in the yard, I want to put signs up on the roof. Up on the side of the building, cover some windows, you know, just election signs, like vote whoever for whatever. I have a few apartment complex numbers and information submitted to me, so I'm going to start with those, see how it goes. Someone who sent me a number before has sent me the exact same number again. That's always a good idea when you don't hear your number called on the podcast, is to just send the number again. Actually, that's a horrible idea. I'm sorry, Jason. I appreciate the submission. I'm going to call it, though. I'm going to see what happens. I don't remember what happened before, but whatever it wasn't funny enough to put on the podcast, apparently. Sometimes when I call these numbers, they don't work out, or they don't answer the phone, or they just don't react hilariously. And when that happens, I don't put the call on the show, because that would be boring for you guys to listen to it if they just, you know, they just hang up on me or don't get angry, or I'm unable to evoke crazy emotions out of them. This time he sent me a picture of all the mailboxes, so I know what the apartment numbers are like.
Forest Hills in the Cabana.
Hello, I'm a tenant here. I just have a question.
Okay.
I was on the roof earlier, and as I was trying to climb down, I knocked the gutter off the side.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm in 2104. It's just above our apartment, the part of the roof above the apartment.
Okay, I'll have Kenny take a look.
Okay.
Thank you.
And also, hello? Well, shit. See, Jason? See? That's probably why it wasn't on the show last time, because she just hangs up on me and doesn't do anything funny. Let me give her a call back, though.
Forest Hills in the Cabanas.
Hi, I was, talking and you hung up on me.
I'm sorry, you had said, I said I'd have Kenny take a look.
Oh, okay, yeah, but I was still talking, and then you just hung right up on me.
Oh, I'm sorry, I thought you had said bye, because I even said thanks, have a good day.
No, I didn't say bye. I didn't say anything that even rhymed with bye. What the fuck?
Okay, what's your name, sir?
This is Tim.
Tim who? Because there's no Tim that lives in 2104, or should be living in 2104.
Well, I sleep on the couch.
Well, then you're illegally there, because you're not on the lease, are you?
You don't need to get snippy with me, I'm just trying to tell you about a problem. Trying to be a good tenant.
You need to quit prank calling. Either you don't live there and you're lying, or you're living there, which is trespassing, and I can call the cops.
I'm not trespassing. I have permission to be here on the couch.
Who gave you that permission? Because you're not on the lease, and we are the only ones that can give you permission, not your person that lives there. They don't own the property.
No, he gave me permission, and he lives here, so it's fine.
There's no he for you to get permission from. Well, the owner of this property is not a he. So,
no, I'm not talking about the owner of the property. I'm talking about the other guy that lives here.
It doesn't matter who lives where. The only person that can give you permission to live, stay there, is a property owner of the actual property.
Okay. But I have a question, though.
Mm-hmm.
I put up a big vinyl sign on the roof, and it kind of overhangs mm-hmm. over where the gutter is.
Yeah, I'm not really sure why you're doing all these prank calls, but it's really annoying.
What prank call? This isn't a prank call. That's weird. Why does she think it's a prank call? So thanks, Jason, for submitting the exact same number again that didn't work out before, because if it had, you would have heard it on the podcast. It looks like it didn't work out again, but at least she got a little upset at me, I guess. Last week, I did about, I'd say, 20 phone calls that didn't work out, and I just erased them. They never showed up on the podcast. So if you submit a number and you never hear it, that's why. I really do look into all of these, though. Very rarely do I just not call them for some reason, which does happen occasionally, but not too often. That's why I'm so behind on these all the time. I'm always like a month behind, because I look into every single number that's sent to me. Hey, look, this request has a big list of numbers. A list of six, anyway. Six different apartment buildings. And he included apartment numbers, so I know which apartment number to say I'm in. So awesome. Thank you, Gavin. This is from Gavin. He says, I really enjoy the snowplow shoe, and especially the terrible tenants, so I did some work, and maybe you can use them. I tried to identify apartment numbers to make it easier, and I list the occupied ones. He says, if this helps, I will work on them in different cities. So awesome. Yeah, this should definitely help. These are all in the same area, so I'm going to change my area code to their area.
Middle Apartments, this is Brittany. How can I help you?
Hello, Brittany. This is Tim. I'm a tenant here.
Mm-hmm.
And I just have a question.
Mm-hmm.
I just wanted to make sure it was okay, because today I'm putting up a big vinyl sign on the roof. It's a political sign. And it's gonna cover the entire front part of the roof above my apartment, and it's gonna hang down in front of the windows a little bit, too. It's really big.
Okay, so you're wanting to see if that's okay, or...
Yeah, well, I didn't know if that would interfere with the gutters if it rained or something. Like, I guess I can move it if it rains, just temporarily.
Hold on 1 second, okay?
All right.
Okay, this is Pam. So, Brittany said you had a question.
Oh, yeah, I just wanted to... I'm putting a gigantic vinyl sign on the roof.
Okay.
It's going to cover most of the roof over my part of the building.
Okay.
It's like a political sign. It's for one of the people running for office. I don't know which one. Like, they're paying.
And who is this?
Who's the political person? I'm not sure.
No, who are you?
Oh, my name is Tim.
Yeah, I'm thinking that's not okay, Tim.
Why not?
Because it's not your building.
Yeah,
can I ask what apartment you live in?
It's my roof, though. It's like my part of the roof. It's like just
yeah.
over. It's only going to affect my apartment. It's going to go. It's going to drape over the side of the roof, and it's going to hang in front of my windows.
So, well, I'm telling you, you can't do that.
Well, I've already done it. It's up.
Okay. Well, we'll go take it down.
Well, no, you
can't. You might want to take it down so you don't lose it.
I just spent a bunch of time putting it up. I like nailed nails through it to hold it onto the roof.
You nailed holes into our roof.
Yeah, just little ones, so it's okay. It's not going to hurt anything.
What's your apartment number?
I'm in 2405.
Okay, yeah, you need to remove it, and if you don't remove it, we will.
Would that have made a difference? Like, you asked what apartment number I was. Like, if I said a different apartment, would you have said, oh, that's fine, you can do it? Whatever.
No, I just want to know where to go get the banner off of the roof.
Well, you can't take it down. Like, it's just got to be up there for the next week until the elections.
Yeah, we absolutely can take it down. And we will.
I don't give you permission to take it down.
We don't need your permission. If you do not remove it, we will.
It's not even, I've already been paid for it, so they already paid me money to put it up. And I signed a contract with them.
I guess you need to go work that out with them then.
Well, no, maybe you do.
So.
Because, you know, you're the one saying you're going to take it down, and it's not yours to take down. I paid money for that.
Yeah. Well, hey, you know what? Let me get someone else for you to talk to, and in the process of that...
Is it going
to
be a man because you can't handle things because you're a woman?
Excuse me?
I didn't say anything. No, it's fine. Go ahead and put him on.
Yeah, let me get him for you.
Okay, thanks. Yeah, I'm sure he'll be able to take care of things. He'll have sense. I get to tell my wacky story to 3 people now.
Hi, this is Amy.
Hi, Amy.
You're Tim?
Yeah.
Okay, what's your last name, Tim? I'm sorry, I'm not really, I've never had any conversations with you.
McDaverson.
Okay. And you have hung a sign on our building?
Yeah, just on the roof, just on the front part of the roof so people can see it. It's.
So you just put holes in our roof without permission?
Yeah, well, I had to nail all around the sides. And I just tried to just put like 3 nails in the top, but it was kind of drooping around in the middle
but
part of it.
I just don't understand why you would feel the need to put holes in somebody else's property.
Well, they're just little holes. They're not going to make leaks or anything.
A little hole wouldn't make a leak through our shingles?
Probably not.
The shingles are there. They're solid for a reason.
Yeah. Well, it's for, I think, Roy Gerbel. He's running for county clerk.
Okay, that really doesn't matter to us. What matters to us is that our buildings have been damaged.
Well, it's really important that he wins the election. I mean, he needs to be the next county clerk.
Okay, I'm kind of starting to think this is a prank call. I really hope it is.
No.
Because I wouldn't hope that anybody that I had living here would feel that it would ever be okay to do that and then try to explain it as some sort of a personal reasoning.
Well, what other reason would it be?
Well, why would you personally damage my property for one of your political feelings?
Well, no, he's paying me to put it up.
Okay, but what am I getting out of it? What makes it okay?
Well, I shouldn't have to give you income, my own income.
No, I think this must be some sort of a prank. That's what I was telling you.
No,
and if there is... If there was to be one found on our building, we would sue whoever did it.
Well, come and look at it. It's right on the roof. I'm not. This isn't a prank.
Okay. Please don't call back, sir.
I'm not going to call back. I just wanted to make sure. I was just being nice. Wait a minute. That wasn't a man. She tricked me. Okay, Gavin. So far, so good. Let me call the second one on the list.
Sunstone Apartments. This is Ryan. Can I help you?
Hello. I'm a tenant here at Sunstone.
Yes.
And my name's Tim. I just needed to find out. I'm going to be painting the front of my just my part of the building.
Sure.
Just the part where I live, around the windows and the door.
You said you're going to be painting it?
Yes, red and blue and white. It's for a political sign. They're paying me to paint the front of my building.
Okay.
And it's going to say Roy Gerbel for county or city clerk is what he's running for.
And you said you're painting your building?
Yeah, just the around the door and window. Just, you know, my part of the building.
Well, that's actually not allowed out here. I mean, if there's a sign or something like that, but yeah, we can't have painting.
Well, people don't even look at the signs anymore is the problem. So, yeah, I've already painted the whole front blue. Like, that's going to be the base color, the background. Then I'm do the red and the white on the rest of it to spell out his name.
Well, and what apartment are you in?
303.
303? Okay.
Yep.
Well, I would advise against doing that, I guess.
Okay. Well, I won't do it next time. I've already started this time, though. The whole thing's blue, so I may as well just finish it, I guess. But the reason I was calling is I need to find out what color the apartment really originally was. Like, if you have a computer code or something, I can give to Home Depot, because I'll probably paint it back eventually, paint it back to the original color, so you'll never even know it was changed.
Well, I mean, that's fine, and we can get that, but, I mean, we would be painting it back, and then there would be a bill to paint it back.
Oh, no, I'm going to do it for free.
Well, we would want someone professional to turn it back.
Oh, no, I used to paint professionally. That's what I did for a living.
Well, I know, and that's fine.
How'd you know that? I never told you that before.
Well, no, I didn't say you did. But
yeah, it's already blue. I just need to do the red and the white today. The main thing, because after this weekend, after the elections, I'll be painting it back.
Well, let me go check out what you've done, and then if I could have your phone number, I can call you back on this.
Okay. 474-1331.
1331. All right, what was your name again?
Tim.
All right.
And I also put a vinyl sign on the roof.
For
the
for
same
like
thing.
Airplanes or
for Kellogg airplanes.
Traffic?
No. It's for, you know, a political sign. They're paying me to do this.
Because
it's in a good location for a lot of people to see it, you know? So it's like a vinyl sign. It covers the entire front of the roof, just over my part of the apartment, though.
And what's the name of the candidate?
Roy Gerbel.
Roy Gerbel?
Yep.
What's he running for?
City clerk.
City clerk?
Yep.
Well, I was wondering if we could get paid, if we had something on our building, too.
Maybe. I don't know. I'm getting $20 for this, just for this one week.
$20?
Yep.
Man, it seems like they could pay a little more for the building and the roof.
Yeah, I don't know. I'm pretty happy with it.
Yeah. Okay, well, I will go check that out and then give you a call back and let you know the paint code and everything like that.
Okay, great.
All right.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Bye. Okay, I don't think... I'm starting to think that guy wasn't buying it. Can't say for sure. I blame Gavin for him not buying it. Thanks a lot, Gavin. Gavin and Michael. Michael, the show sponsor. But mostly Gavin.
Thank you for calling the Villas of Waterford. This is Megan. How can I help you?
Hello, I'm a tenant here at the Villas.
Okay.
And I have a question.
Sure. What can I help you with?
Well, I'm painting the front of my apartment, just around the door and the windows, just on my part, you know? I'm sorry?
Okay.
Well, I need to know, like, the original color, because I'm going to paint it back in a couple weeks. But the original color, I don't... I need to know the original color so I can buy that to paint it back. Like if you have...
Well, you're not supposed to paint your apartment.
Well, no, it's
That's
just...
part of your lease paperwork.
No, it's
in
just
your lease, it states
that there is no alterations of the apartment, which includes painting or wallpapering.
Yeah. Well, this is just temporary. It's for the elections, because it's like a political sign, but instead of putting a sign out in the yard, I'm painting the entire front as a sign.
Yeah, you can't do that.
Well, I've already started. I already painted the whole thing blue. Like, it's going to be blue and red and white, and I'm going to paint the red and the white on top of the blue.
What apartment do you live in?
3202.
Okay, that's absolutely not allowed. Is it on the outside of the apartment?
Yeah, on the entire, all the way from the roof down to the bottom. And it's all blue right now. I just have to finish it. But I was just thinking, you know, in a couple of weeks, I'll probably paint it back. So I need to know the original color so I can go, you know.
Honestly, I'm speechless.
Well, it's not even a permanent thing. It's just temporary. It's just for the elections.
I understand, but we can't have that on our side of our building. We have no political affiliation. We can't have that kind of stuff in our complex.
What? We can't even put signs? We can't put signs up in the grass even?
No.
Oh, because that's what I did last year.
That's in your lease. You're not allowed to do that.
Oh, well, it's too...
And painting our buildings without our permission is huge.
No, it's just for a week or two.
Just it doesn't matter.
Until the elections are over, and you'll never know it was changed.
The election is tomorrow.
Oh, yeah, we'll see. It's good I'm getting this done today, then.
Please, are you joking? Are you messing with me?
No, of course not. You haven't noticed the vinyl sign on the roof?
A vinyl sign on the roof?
Yeah, you know, like a big vinyl cloth thing that covers part of the roof, the part where I live.
No.
Because that's been up there almost a week now. I put it up there last Tuesday. I nailed it into the roof.
You were on our roof?
Yeah.
And you nailed?
Just four nails. You know, just one on each corner.
What apartment did you say you live in?
3202.
What's your name?
Tim.
And your last name, Tim?
McDaverson.
I think you've called the wrong apartment complex.
Oh, no. It's on Silver Springs Boulevard.
No, I'm not on Silver Springs Boulevard.
Where's this one at?
I'm clear on the other side of town. The Villas of Waterford is not located anywhere near Silver Springs Boulevard.
Oh, well, that's my old address.
What old address?
No, I'm giving you the right apartment. No, I'm on East 20.
We're done here on the phone. Whatever you're talking about, you're pulling my leg, and I don't believe you, so I need to get off the phone with you.
I'm on East 29th Street. I thought you meant my old
address.
Then
why did you say Silver Springs Boulevard?
I thought you were talking about my old address.
Now you're just being unbelievable.
No, I'm not. This is completely believable.
Yes, you are. I'm not going to continue this conversation. If you want to speak to to me again, you'll have to figure out your issue, okay?
There's no issue. I've already done the painting. I just want to be able to paint it back.
We're not having this conversation anymore. I'm going to go look at the side of the building, and if it's not blue, I don't believe you.
Well, why don't you put me on hold and go check it? Put me on hold and go check it.
I don't understand why you're wasting my time.
I didn't think I was wasting my time. It's for an important political issue. Oh, man, I messed that up. I had the address pulled up for the other apartment building, for the one before that I called, and I told her the wrong address. So I had to quickly Google the number. So that one was going really good until I messed it up with the wrong address. But the good part is that she is walking out around the building right now, trying to find the blue apartment. And Gavin, he even had the address listed on that one. I didn't notice it. Because he didn't have the address on the first three. He just has them on the last three. So I blame Gavin for that mistake. God damn it, Gavin. All your fault.
Thank you for calling Silver Springs. This is Sarah. How can I help you?
Hello, Sarah. I'm a tenant here at Silver Springs.
Uh-huh.
And I broke the glass out of a few of my front windows.
Okay.
And, you know, just the panes of glass, because they slipped out of my hands when I was trying to set them down.
Okay.
And is that something you guys would take care of?
We can get it fixed,
but you will be responsible for the charges for it.
Oh, how much is a pane of glass?
I don't know. We'll have to check and see and get quotes on it, so.
Oh, because I broke four of them.
Okay.
Four separate ones.
What apartment are you in?
I'm in 2106.
Okay.
I was going to, it's for the election that's tomorrow. I was pulling the panes of glass out, and I was replacing the panes of glass with those political signs, those plastic ones.
Okay. And then the glass broke on all of them?
Yeah. Well, I dropped the last pane of glass. I dropped it on all the others, and it shattered all of them.
Okay.
Yeah. I thought I found a loophole, you know, because we're not allowed to put the election signs in the yard.
Yeah.
So I just was going to replace the windows with signs.
Uh-huh. Yeah, and I honestly don't even think they're supposed to be up in the windows.
Yeah, well, they're not in the windows. They are the windows.
Yeah, I know, and I don't believe that they're supposed to be up there at all either.
Oh, okay. Well, I don't think it says anything in the rental agreement about them actually being okay. The windows.
Okay, well, I'll have to check on it, and then I'll call you back, and I'll have to check on the quote for the windows.
Okay.
All right.
And also, I put that big vinyl banner up on the roof. That's okay, right? Since it's not in the lawn.
You put a vinyl banner on the roof?
Yes. It's really large. It covers my entire section. Actually, it overhangs a little bit on the other tenants.
No, you won't be able to have that up there either.
Well, just for the rest of the day, because the election's tomorrow.
It'll have to come down.
Yeah, it'll come down tomorrow after the election.
It's not supposed to be up there at all, so it'll have to come down today.
Well, it's going to be hard to get it down because I nailed it in with a bunch of nails.
Okay. What apartment are you in?
2106.
Okay, and what's your name?
Tim.
Tim?
Yes, Tim. T-I-M.
Okay, and you live at Silver Springs?
Yes, uh-huh.
In 2106?
Yes.
Okay, that's not who we have as current resident in 2106.
Yeah, well, I'm just staying here with him. I sleep on the couch.
In 2106?
Yes.
Okay, and what are the names of the people in the apartment?
Why do you need that?
Well, because you're saying that you live there, and so that's why I'm wondering if you... Because I don't have anybody else... I don't have any name by the name of Tim in that apartment.
Yeah, I wouldn't be on the lease. I'm not allowed... I can't find a rental anywhere because of my past record, both with landlords and, criminal record, and credit too.
Okay.
That's why I just stay with friends.
Okay, so what are the names of the people that you're staying with?
Well, Todd's one of them.
Okay, there's nobody by that name in that apartment either.
Oh, well, I'm sure it's 2106. It's the one, if you come by, you'll see the one with the windows replaced with paper, or cardboard. Plastic. Okay. Plastic is what it is.
Okay. I don't believe that you're in 2106. I mean, that's not a name that is on the lease either.
Well,
so
there's several people living here. Maybe I'm just subleasing from one of the other subleasers.
Okay. And you're positive you're in 2106?
Oh, yeah, without a doubt.
Okay. What's your phone number?
474-1331.
Okay. And your name's Tim?
Tim McDaverson.
Can you spell the last name?
Uh-huh. M-C-D-A-V-E-R.
Okay. D-A-V?
Uh-huh. Yep. Yep.
E-R-S-O-N?
Yep, that's it.
Okay. And what was the names of the residents in that apartment?
Well, I just know Todd and Matthew. There's this other guy. He's really quiet. I don't really know. I don't talk to him.
Okay. All right. Well, I'll get back to you on this.
Okay, but I don't have to take the sign off the roof, do I? Because it's really important. It's just for the election until tomorrow.
Yeah, the sign's going to have to come off the roof.
Well, I don't have a ladder anymore because I borrowed it from someone else, and he's in jail now.
Okay. Well, I'll have to check on all of this and get back to you.
Okay. So do you guys have a ladder?
All right.
So I can climb up on the roof?
We don't have a ladder that we can let you borrow.
Well, how would I take it off even then?
Well, I mean, you got it up there somehow, so...
Yeah, but that guy, he's not available anymore. He got...
Okay, I'll talk to the manager about this, and I'll get back to you.
Okay, but I mean, it's going to be really hard to tear it out because I put nails all around the edge and all through the middle because it was sagging too much, and I wanted it to look really good.
Okay, again, I'll get back to you.
All right.
All right, thank you.
Whatever.
Bye.
That was a slam. If she had one of those old phones, 60s Bell phones, it probably sounded like this on her end. Okay, one left for Gavin's list. One of them didn't answer, by the way, so that's why we're one short.
Thank you for calling Newport Apartments. This is Melanie. How can I help you?
Hello, I'm a tenant here at Newport. I just have a question.
Sure.
I was wondering if there's a way I can get... do you have any extra paint, like the outer paint that goes around on the apartment, on the outside of the apartment?
We do not provide any paint for
We don't
provide that. I think what you can do is we can write down the color swatch for you, like the number,
mm-hmm.
and then you can go to Sherman Williams and
that'd be perfect.
See if they can do that for you.
Okay, all right.
You need exterior paint?
Yeah, exterior paint, and enough to cover the entire front of my apartment, because that's what I've painted blue.
Outside of the house?
Mm-hmm.
You painted outside?
Yeah, I painted the entire thing around my door, windows, from the roof, the top of the roof, all the way to the down to the ground, you know?
Are you sure you're not talking... You didn't paint the inside, not the outside.
Oh, no, I didn't paint the inside, just the outside. I'm painting...
Like your patio?
Yeah, I'm painting an election sign for people who drive by to see. And it's for this guy who's running for county clerk, city clerk,
What community are you calling? You live here and you're painting the exterior of the building?
Yeah. Temporarily, you know, just for the election. It's to help the candidate.
No, you're going to have to... That's the kind of stuff you have to get approval. You can't paint the exterior of the building.
Well, it's too late. It's almost finished. Like, I've laid down the base color, and now I've just got to paint the red and the white over the top of it to show his name and what he's running for and stuff.
Yeah, you should not have done that.
Oh, well, it's too late now. But anyway, that's not the point. Like, you know, I'll be painting it back.
What apartment are you in?
I'm in 308.
There's no way you're in 308. We don't face the street.
So you're saying this is all for nothing?
Our building 308 does not face the street.
Right, yeah, but some of the neighbors will see it, and it'll make them think twice about who they elect for city clerk.
308 is vacant here.
No, I have squatter's rights.
No.
What do you mean, no?
308's vacant. Can you hold one moment, please?
Okay.
Because we offer you many wonderful recreational facilities and programs.
Oh, this isn't going well.
On top of the list,
I should just hang up now.
Perfect for a Sunday afternoon stroll.
Thank you for holding. Was there something I can help you with?
Is this a different person?
Yes, sir.
Okay, yeah, that stupid lady before, she wasn't even listening to me. I live in 1411.
In 1411?
Yeah.
Okay, what's your name?
She's so retarded. My name is Tim Daverson. I already gave her this. Did she not even write it down? She needs to be fired or something.
I'm sorry about that. I apologize that there was a miscommunication.
You should be. Oh, my God.
I didn't hear anything. I just caught the phone because it was ringing back again. You said 1411?
Yeah. That lady I talked to before, okay. Oh, my God. She's mentally challenged or something. But, yeah, I just painted the whole front of the building blue. I mean, just the part where I live. And she's freaking out about it.
Well, I could understand, because you're not supposed to paint anything without permission from the office.
She really didn't tell you about any of this? She just put you on the phone?
No, she didn't put me on the phone. I grabbed it because it rang back.
Oh, I see. Okay, yeah, I'm just painting the front of my apartment building because for the elections tomorrow.
Okay,
I'm painting an election sign on the side of the building.
And what is your name again?
My name is Tim McDaverson.
Okay, Tim, I don't have your name in my system anywhere, and I can't find you listed on apartment number 1411 either.
I've already been through all this with that other stupid lady. I'm not on the lease. I just sleep on the couch here.
Okay. And so what made you think it was okay to paint the outside of the building in an apartment you don't lease?
Well, I didn't sign anything, so it doesn't matter to me. But it's just for the election, and I'm going to paint it back next week. I'm going to paint it back.
You can't do that.
Well, yeah, I'm going to.
It's not your personal property. You can't do that.
Well, I used to paint for a living, so it's not like I'm not a professional or anything.
Well, that still doesn't matter. It's not your personal property.
Okay. Well, I mean, it's already done. I've already done the base color, and right now I'm painting the red and the white. You know, to put the candidate's name and what he's running for up. And it's just for the election. It'll be gone after tomorrow night.
That's not okay. That's not acceptable. It's not acceptable in any terms of our lease. It's not acceptable.
Mm-hmm. I didn't sign the lease.
Well, it doesn't matter if you didn't sign the lease. If you didn't sign the lease, then it's becoming vandalism, sir.
Well, no, I live here.
Well, not if you didn't sign the lease. You're not legally supposed to be living here.
Yeah. And I put a vinyl banner on the roof, too. I nailed that into the roof. And that's just for this week, too.
You went on the roof.
Mm-hmm.
How did you do that?
What do you mean, how?
Yeah. How?
You
got a ladder that was tall enough to go up three stories?
Yeah. I borrowed it from my friend Steve.
And who is the leaseholder on your apartment?
Brandon.
Brandon who?
Who knows? I don't know. We're not that formal, really. I just pay him and I sleep on the couch.
Interesting.
Is it interesting? Because it doesn't seem very
interesting.
It is interesting to me.
Because 1411 doesn't have anybody living in it right now.
Oh my God, is this entire place vacant?
No.
Because that's what that other stupid lady said about 308.
Well, I'm...
But anyway, I have squatter's rights and you can't throw me out.
Well, this is private property.
Yeah, but I have squatter's rights. You know, you need to learn what the law is about, you know, tenants. Because I'm your tenant now, even though I don't pay.
Oh. Okay, well,
So I'm not going anywhere, lady.
Okay.
Good. I'm glad I put you in your place. Both me and my vinyl banner on the roof are staying. I'm going to paint all the apartments blue.
Well, that's vandalism, and you can get arrested for that.
That's your opinion.
Really? Do you want me to call the police right now? I can put you on hold while I call them.
Why don't you put them on three-way? Don't you know how to work the phone?
I don't know how to do that on this phone.
You don't know how to make a three-way call? It's really easy. What phone system are you using? Is it a Cisco phone?
No, sir.
Didn't they teach you how to do your job before you got a job there?
Well, they taught me how to do the things I needed to know how to do, and how to three-way call is not really something that happens very often.
Well, it'd be really useful right now because you could three-way the police on.
I'm just going to have to end this phone conversation, and if you truly are vandalizing our property, we will be calling the police.
It's not vandalism. I live here. I have squatter's rights.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
I have squatter's rights. Oh. Okay, thanks, Gavin, for those apartment numbers. That was kind of fun. I don't know if I'm going to continue with this or not, because I don't know. What else can I say, really? They sure do freak out, though, when I get on their roof. I think I need to say that I'm on their roofs more often. They sure don't like that. It's time for us to do some news. I haven't done news in a while. I found an interesting article this past week. It's a consumer alert from the Washington, D.C. area. It says, be aware of caller ID spoofing. And this is a news report. It's just 2 minutes long. I'm going to play the whole thing. And it's kind of funny because they don't seem to understand what caller ID spoofing is.
Now 7 is on your side with a consumer alert. We're hearing from a Fairfax County man who was the victim of telephone spoofing.
Holy crap, this guy's old.
This is when someone uses your name and number to repeatedly call other people, then hang up.
See, that's not the definition of caller ID spoofing. Calling someone and hanging up.
As Jennifer Donlin reports, it's become a widespread problem.
It started 10 days ago. Incessant telephone ringing. With angry callers on the line.
The gist was, I keep getting phone calls from you. If I pick up, it's just a hang-up. Why are you doing this to me?
So this guy, he reminds me of Grouchy Old Man. He's just some old guy. And they're showing pictures of his phone and answering machine. He uses a phone and answering machine that looks like they're from the 80s, maybe early 90s.
Frank is a retired Fairfax County resident. He said his personal information has been showing up on other people's caller IDs. When they pick up, the phone hangs up.
Yes, they know my name and my number. That's why they're able to call me back and say, cut this out.
It's called telephone spoofing, or in Frank's case, caller ID spoofing. Someone's using his name and number to repeatedly call people and hang up.
Some of them would say up to about half a dozen within the course of a single afternoon.
It got so bad,
I've decided not to answer my phone.
And he changed the recording on his answering machine.
You are calling because you think I am calling you and hanging up. I am not guilty.
It's a pretty big annoyance.
Not guilty.
Because you just know you're innocent and you had nothing to do with this.
We called his service provider, which said it was an industry-wide problem. It turns out you can even go online to learn how to spoof someone's caller ID. The federal government tackled caller ID spoofing after telemarketers used the tactic to trick people into answering their phones. There's a Truth in Caller ID Act of 2009. It basically prohibits the use of telephone spoofing for the purpose of defrauding someone or causing harm. The problem with this case is there's no one on the other line. What's the point?
Some sort of joke.
A joke, Frank said, is not funny, no matter which side of the line you're on.
It's a problem you can't do anything about, so you feel both kind of violated and helpless.
In Fairfax County, Jennifer Donnellan, ABC 7 News.
Now, if you believe you've been the victim of caller ID spoofing, you can call your telephone carrier. Many carriers have set up call centers as they continue to track these issues. Gordon?
The victim of caller ID spoofing. And the only thing I can think of that would be is, you know, telemarketers, they use the automated dialing things that call like a bunch of numbers all at once. And then when the person picks up, they, a live person is transferred onto the line and they try to sell them something. But a lot of times they can't get a rep to you quick enough, so the phone just kind of hangs up or just sits there in silence for a few seconds until a rep can finally get on the line. That's my guess. I'm probably wrong, though, because it seems like he would also get calls from people who have actually been talked to by the telemarketers. And when I watched this story a few days ago, I was really excited because I'm like, holy crap, I'm going to call this guy and talk to him and it's going to be hilarious. But no, in the article, it says Frank, whose last name he prefers not to share since his identity has already been compromised. So I don't see how I can get his number if his last name's not on there. Could have been hilarious, though. I could have hacked that old-ass Radio Shack answering machine from the video.
Yo, what's up, Brad? This is PLA Guard 9. I just want to say that, you know, I miss everything. You know, PLA Radio, the phone show. At least you're doing all amazing with the Snowplow Show and
aw, shucks.
On your YouTube page that you had two other women named Mildred Monday that you called and you fucked with, like, that you did the same thing with the original one. So keep doing your shit and find me on the forum and you should post to me or I'll make you eat a book. All right, see ya, Brad.
Crap, not that. Thanks for that recap of what I'm doing these days.
Hey, Brad, RBCP. Hope you're happy now. Now you're getting $5 from me a month now.
Yay!
For doing shitty shows. So I hope you're happy now. Thanks a lot. Have a good night.
Be happier for getting $10, you fucking cheapskate. God. No, sorry, I'm kidding. I appreciate everyone that's contributing to the show. That's why more shows are happening and I'm doing more things. Being forced to do more things. But it's okay. I need the motivation. As long as we're talking about Patreon, though, I need to tell you guys something. I spent $650 today. This company charged my debit card from Patreon money. It was like 100% Patreon money. And we're having a PLA coin made. That's the kind of crap I'm blowing your money on, is a PLA coin. It's going to be a metal coin. It's going to be silver. It has the Phone Loser logo on each side. It says Roy, New Mexico, 2014. It's going to be a very limited edition because I'm never going to make that particular coin again. And the reason is because the next coin is going to be even better next year, the 2015 coin. But I've been working on this for the past few weeks. I got them to submit me proofs and stuff, and I'm more or less happy with the design. And this company makes some really amazing coins. If you want to see what they can do, the website is challengecoinsforless.com. But it's not spelled F-O-R-4, it's the number 4. That's how you know you're working with a reputable company, is when they mix in random numbers with letters. The only thing that would be better is if they put a few hyphens in their URL. Maybe make it a .cc domain instead of a .com. No, just kidding. It's okay. I looked into these people. But I think within 3 weeks, I'm going to have a gigantic box of PLA money, which is going to be the coolest thing ever. And this absolutely would not have happened without Patreon, without you people supporting the show and all the other projects on phonelosers.org. So thanks, you guys. You Patreon people that get things in the mail every month, be looking forward to getting coins in the mail on the December package. Not the November one, but the December one. Your November package is probably going to be crap because I blew all the money this month on coins. So I hope you're all excited about that. I sure am. I think this will be much cooler than those stupid old ID cards I was making. Oh, and another thing. People have been asking me about those ID cards. They want to know where to get them because I always forgot to list them in the Phone Losers store. So this past weekend, I worked on the store page on phonelosers.org and I got the ID cards up there. You can now order them. I made them $5. If you can't afford $5, a dollar would be nice. You know, that would just cover shipping. But yeah, those are up there now. I put everything on Bandcamp. I got rid of the stupid WordPress software I was using for my store, and I'm just selling everything through Bandcamp now. Because why not? So go to phonelosers.org and click on the store button, phonelosers.org/store, and buy some crap. And if you're not a Patreon person, hopefully there will be coins left. In the end, there'll be some coins up there, and you can have a PLA coin. I'm excited about the coins.
I love you, Roy. Please make sweet, passionate love to me.
Okay.
Yeah. Hey, okay. I'm going to keep it under a minute.
Yeah.
And
it's true. This one is 50 seconds long.
Hey, thank you. I'm going to follow the rules. No performance art. Only 2 phone calls a week maximum.
I've got you guys trained so well.
And keep it under a minute. And I will try to stay sober and not leave incoherent, stupid.
Sober's boring. Come on.
Message. So, okay. Well, I usually leave stupid, incoherent things because I get drunk when I listen to your shows. So, help me stay sober and quit drinking and just don't do shows.
Okay.
And
I'm going to delete this show right now.
It'll be awesome. Yeah. I love you. You're a great guy. Oh. Your art and stuff. Yeah. Okay. Hey, whoop. I'm going to make it shorter than a minute. Cactus, cactus, cactus. Come on.
That was a nice voicemail. And you're complimenting my art after I made fun of your art so much before. I am sorry I'm always such a jerk to everyone in the voicemails. I appreciate the calls. I just couldn't handle the volume of that guy for a while. Okay, see, you hear that? You hear that guy's voice?
This fucking channel is really fucking good.
Seems like I get those more often than I should, and I never play them. Like, usually I would just delete that, but just so you guys know, maybe I'm not ignoring your voicemail, maybe I just didn't play it because it sounds like this.
Fucking legend, this shit. You're fucking legend, less than 1,000 fucking views.
What the hell?
Less than 100 fucking views. I don't get it. The fuck, man. Where is everyone?
Jeez, get a new phone. It sounds like it would have been such a good voicemail had you had a good phone, too. Seems like you had a lot to say in there.
Bad cutter! Pull down your pants! I'm gonna fuck you.
Oh, yeah, I was totally fooled there in the beginning.
Hey, during the last show, somebody called in and said this.
Money is the root of all evil, like they say. Then why do they ask for it in church?
Money is not the root of all evil. The love of money is the root of all evil, you idiot. Cactus, cactus.
Yeah, Gloria, you idiot. Hey, you know how Google Voice, they always do the voice translation of your voicemail so I can read what the voicemails say before I play them, which is very useful because if I see one that begins, I'm calling about the Craigslist ad, I can just delete it without even listening. I'm going to read you the translation of that one that I just played. We doing, Russia's some. The called and said this, hi Claudine. All okay, and I ask away, and sheriff, money is not the river. We will a lot of money through. We will you be at discuss this. That's pretty much how all the translations are with Google Voice, but they're still useful. I still read them all the time. Just, you know, some of them are more hilarious than others are. Okay, enough of this. Let's call some more apartment buildings. I'm just going to call a couple more, because, wow, I'm up to over 50 minutes already. Need to wrap this up. You guys don't want 2-hour-long shows, do you? I need to start doing shorter shows so I can do more shows. Fool you into thinking I'm doing more shows, but really they're just 30 minutes long. Yeah, that's what I need to do. It looks like all of the ones that have been submitted to me are from the East Coast, and I can't really call those because it's after 5 over there. I don't think they're going to pick up. So let me get on Craigslist, call up a few from the West Coast.
Thank you for calling Bella Woods. This is Brittany. How may I help you?
Hello, this is Todd. I'm a tenant here.
Okay.
At the building, and I just had a question. I'm up in the attic crawl space right now, and there's a wasp nest up here.
Okay. And you're in your apartment?
Yeah, uh-huh.
Oh, I didn't even know people could get in those.
Used to we couldn't, but I put a hole in the ceiling so I could get up there.
Oh, okay. What is your apartment?
It's 105 or 1021.
Okay, and then what's your building number?
Oh, I'm not sure about that. I get all my mail at a P.O. box.
Okay, what is your last name?
Stevenson.
Stevenson. Do you have a roommate or anything?
Nope.
What, and your first name is Todd?
Yeah. Uh-huh, yep.
Okay, I will send somebody over. Yeah, you can do
that. Okay, and, well, I can't come down right now because I'm trying to finish this job, but I just thought you might want to, you know, have...
Okay, so you're not at home right now?
No, I'm at home, but I'm just in the crawl space, and I've crawled way far down on top of other people's apartments, too. That's where the wasp nest is.
Okay. Okay, thanks.
And I've just got to finish what I'm doing up here, but I just thought you might want to know about the wasp nest.
Okay.
Okay, and do you know if will they come and spray that then soon?
Yes, I'm going to talk to the maintenance supervisor and the asset manager.
And do they need access to my new, my new access hatch that I built?
Well, I'm kind of confused because, so you actually put a hole in your ceiling?
Yeah, but it looks really good. It's a square hole, and now there's a, you know, it opens up and stuff.
Okay, and, I don't really think you're supposed to do that.
Oh, well, I had to get up into the attic crawl space so I could put in the aluminum foil.
Okay. Did a manager tell you to do that?
No. It's just to block out the electromagnetic radiation from the sun.
Okay, let me get a good phone number for you.
But I'm gonna put the aluminum foil up along the entire length of the roof over everyone's apartments, because I think
I think you're supposed to be doing stuff like that.
That'll be the safest to block out electromagnetic radiation for everyone, not just me. Because if I leave
I'm gonna put you on a brief hold.
If I leave it open on their side, it'll. All right, they never want to hear my stories. I was thinking I could put holes in the roof from the inside, because I'm using nails to hang up the aluminum foil. I'm going to turn this whole apartment into a Faraday cage. That's what I'm going to do.
Are you still there?
Uh-huh, yep.
Okay, when you get out of the crawl space, can you find out what building you're in so then we can send somebody over there?
Is D a building?
No, it'll be numbers.
Oh, what kind of numbers is it?
We have 17 buildings, so it could be any combination. And you don't have a roommate, right?
Oh, it's number 3 then, because that looks like a D. I'm sorry, I wear...
Number 3? Okay.
Yeah, because I wear...
You're in building 3?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, and, thanks so much.
And I'm putting nails through the roof to tack up this aluminum foil.
Okay.
And so I just... A warning, if you guys ever get on the roof, you'll probably feel the nails poking at your feet.
Okay, great. Thanks so much.
Because, the nails, they go all the way through. I couldn't find short nails. Were more expensive, oddly enough.
Okay. Okay, well, I'll let the manager that you're doing that for her.
Okay, thank you.
Thanks so much.
Thanks for putting me on speaker. All right, she didn't get angry.
Winner Management, this is Allison.
Hello, I have a question. I'm a tenant here.
Okay.
And I'm up in the attic crawl space right now. And I'm tacking aluminum foil on the underside of all the roof.
Okay.
And I found there's a wasp nest up here. I don't know if it's occupied or not. I don't see any wasps. Should I just go ahead and chisel that down with my hammer?
So, which unit are you at?
105.
And what... You're a tenant?
Yes.
Okay. And what was the, we don't have a 105.
I said 102.
Oh, I thought you said 105. Sorry.
Oh, it's okay.
safety. And in the attic, you're doing what again?
I'm tacking aluminum foil to the underside of the entire roof, the whole length of the roof.
Okay.
Yep, and there's a wasp nest up here. And actually, it's kind of in my way, because I want to tack the aluminum foil on that part, but the wasp nest is in the way. Should I just put the aluminum foil over it? Maybe that'll suffocate them if they're in there.
Okay, could you hold on a moment?
Okay.
Thanks.
.com and clicking Inric's drive time search.
Hello, this is Jay.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi.
So I was talking to Allison, and she said, did you find a bee's hive up in the attic?
Yeah. It's I don't know if it's occupied or not.
Oh. What were you doing up in the attic?
I'm tacking aluminum foil all along the underside of the roof. I'm just nailing aluminum foil to the bottom of the roof.
For what reason?
Just to keep out the electromagnetic waves.
Mm.
You know, just a precaution. Safety.
I don't know. Safety from what?
Just from the electromagnetic waves.
Okay. I'm asking because normally we don't want anything done to properties without owner permission.
Oh, well, it's up in the attic, so that's all right. It's not like anyone can see it. And it'll be good for the next tenant, so they won't have to be, you know, deal with the electromagnetic waves.
Well, I don't know that there's a problem with them, but...
Oh, there is. There is. Do you listen to Art Bell?
No.
Oh, there's a problem.
No, I don't. Oh, boy. Okay, well, let's focus on the hive for a minute, because what we normally do, and I can email you the form...
Okay.
But what we normally do is have tenants submit a form,
mm-hmm.
and then we'll have a professional look at it.
Okay.
I don't know if it's active or not, but we would want to give it to our maintenance team and let them take a look at it.
Well,
That's the proper protocol.
I was thinking, you know, I could just put the aluminum foil over this hive, and maybe that would just suffocate them. Because they're in my way from this job I'm doing.
What unit are you in?
102.
2160?
Mm-hmm, yep. And I went ahead, you know, I'm in the crawl space. I went to all the way down the apartment buildings. You know, I'm doing everyone's roofs because I have a lot of aluminum foil.
Are you Aaron or Eric?
This is Aaron.
Oh, Aaron.
Yeah.
The only reason I'm a little bit worried about that, Aaron, is I, of course, know the property owner. And if anything, if tenants are to do anything to the property, they need the owner's permission.
Yeah, well, I can take it down after I'm done. I'll just have to I'll pull all the nails out that I'm nailing up into the bottom to nail this aluminum foil up. That shouldn't be a problem. You know, I'll just take it. It's like if I put a shelf up and then I take it down whenever I leave.
Right. Well, it even says in the lease that you're not supposed to hang anything on the walls without permission.
What, even pictures?
Yeah.
We hung our TV. We hung our television up. Is that, were we not supposed to do that?
Not without permission. We're not supposed to put holes in the walls.
Yeah. We have this big console TV. We hung it up.
I mean, people have done it, Aaron. Don't get me wrong. People have done it. But we like to know about it.
Yeah, well, this isn't like a TV or anything. This is just aluminum foil. Now, I'm pretty sure the nails aren't too long, so I don't think they're going to poke out through the shingles on top of the roof. So it should be okay.
Well, that's my point. What if the nails are too long and you're putting holes in the roof?
Yeah, no, I went out and looked, and I don't see any nails poking up, so I'm pretty sure it's okay.
Mm.
But, I mean, the important thing is the electromagnetic radiation won't be a problem. And I think even if there was a leak from any holes in the roof, the aluminum foil will catch it. What was that noise?
I'm sorry, I dropped the phone. Can you hear me, Aaron?
Oh, did you faint or something?
What's that?
Did you faint?
No.
It's hard to hear you now. It's almost as if I'm on speaker.
Yeah, I put you on speaker so I could have my hands free.
Oh, what are you doing with your hands?
I just wanted to take notes.
I think I hear someone giggling.
Anyway,
are you just making fun of me now?
No, not at all. I wanted to hear why you were doing the aluminum foil so I could make notes. The electromagnetic, what was the radio program you listened to?
Art Bell? It's called Coast to Coast.
Coast to Coast. And what does he say?
Well, I can barely hear you. This isn't going to work. I'm just going to get going. I've got to finish doing this. I'm going to do like all the way down the row of houses. I'm doing everyone's. So everyone's protected.
No, we don't allow that, Aaron.
Well, I've already done half of it. I've done all of my part and all of the next door neighbor's part, and then now I'm moving on down to the third one.
And you didn't have permission to do that, Aaron.
Yeah, and these people, by the way, these people three houses down, they're really noisy down there. I have half of mine to start banging on the ceiling and tell them to quieten down while I'm doing this work.
Well, we can address that, but I'm more worried about you putting a bunch of holes in the ceiling, attic ceiling without permission.
It's just, they're short nails. I don't think they'll poke through. And Eric said it's okay. I asked Eric.
Eric doesn't own the property.
Well, yeah, but, you know, he's lived here a long time, so.
Well, we're going to have to deal with this, Aaron. I'm going to have to talk to the property owner. I don't foresee him being happy about it.
No, I've got it all under control here. I'll skip this row here with the wasp nest. I'll skip this one, and I'll just go down to the next, the next section.
Well, just don't go any further. I'll call you back.
Okay. Well, I got to go all the way to the end, so it's complete. Because, their electromagnetic radiation might leak through if I don't have them protected, too.
Well, like I said, we need to have you halt at the moment until we figure out what to do.
Okay. I'll halt as soon as I'm finished up here.
If you proceed, Aaron, we're going to fine you heavily and maybe have you replace all that wood.
No, you can't find me. You can't find me.
Immediately.
You can't find me. I know my rights as a tenant.
You think you can alter the property that you don't own?
Well, I'm not altering anything. I'm just hanging something up. That's like hanging
without permission, and you're putting holes in the attic ceiling.
It's like hanging a picture is all it is.
Well, like I said, I'm advising you not to proceed. I'm going to call the property owner.
Okay, and I'm almost out of these 1.5-inch nails. I'm going to have to start using the 2.5-inch nails.
Are you at 8204?
Yeah. Well, that's our home line. I'm on my cell phone.
Okay, what's your cell phone number?
Oh, it's on caller ID. Just look it up. Don't be lazy. You got your hands free, right? You can push those caller ID buttons. What'd she say about me? What'd that lady just say? I can hear you because we're on speaker now.
Oh, she was just walking by.
No, I heard her. I heard her say my name. I heard her say something condescending about me. I'm gonna put her on my list.
Okay.
Oh, that's better.
Okay.
Oh,
wow. Okay, I'll call you right back.
Okay. All right, quickly. I gotta call that number now.
Hello.
Hello, is this Aaron?
Yep.
Hey, this is Gary from the rental office for your townhouse there.
Oh, okay.
Yep. We have a little bit of a problem.
Okay.
We're going to have to ask you to move just because of all the issues you've been giving us.
What's that?
We're going to have to ask you to move. We put the eviction notice on your door 5 days ago and you never responded. So we're going to need you to get out by this coming Wednesday. 2 days.
Yeah, we never got one of those.
Oh, we put it on your door. We taped it on your door, and I took a picture of it on your door, so it was definitely there.
Are you sure you got the right address?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, 102.
Okay.
Yeah, I know who I'm evicting. Both you and Eric need to get out of there.
And what's the reason for that?
Who's that person in the background? Can you tell her to shut?
Oh, I'm at work right now.
Oh, okay. Yeah, just tell her to be quiet.
What's the reason for this?
Just in general, all the problems you've been causing us, and the weed. I know weed's legal, but it's against our policy, and it's disturbing the other tenants. They can smell it. Keep getting all those complaints, and we know you've gone up into the attic crawl space, and that's not allowed. I don't know if it was you or Eric, but we have
this is all completely new to me because I didn't hear about any notice. We haven't seen any notice. My roommate got one. He never showed me anything. I've never heard of any complaints before.
No, Eric confessed everything to us, so we know everything. So you don't have to pretend.
Okay. Why is this call coming from Marysville, and why are you not my local...
Because it's from the corporate office. It dials through the corporate office whenever we call. It's our phone system.
So you're saying that 5 days ago you put a notice on our door?
Yeah, God damn it. Why didn't you respond to it, you deadbeat?
Okay, who is this?
Oh, it's Dave. I'm just kidding with you.
Dave who?
Dave from the office. I was just joshing.
What?
was just joshing with you.
Okay, no, but who is Dave from the office? Because I work with the Dave, but you're not him.
Oh, no, from the rental office.
Okay.
You know, like, so, Steve, he takes care of all the tenants and stuff, and I just thought it'd be funny to get in his computer just to prank him and you know, just mess with all the tenants in the computer.
So you actually work for...
Yeah. And Steve, he's out right now, so I thought I'd get on his computer and just call up some of his tenants as a joke. Because he's always playing...
Oh, okay.
He's always playing pranks on me. So I'm like, oh, I'm going to get him back.
So you're Steve, or you're Dave who works with Steve at the Marysville?
Yes. I'm glad you understand. You know, it's just a joke. And
What's your last name, Dave?
I think we sure got him good.
Yeah, what's your last name, Dave?
McDaverson.
Dave McDaverson.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, so I don't know who you are, and I don't recognize the voice, and I don't know how you got my phone number, but you have a good rest of your day, Dave.
All right, you too. I'm glad you understand the joke and think it's hilarious. I think I could have done so much better with that, but I was rushed and panicked. I didn't know what to say to him. Okay, that's it. This show's going on way too long. It's time to quit. Thanks for listening, everyone. Thank you, Michael, for sponsoring the show, even though that was months ago, like earlier this year. I can't believe that apartment guy gave me his tenant's phone number. Names and phone numbers. Why do they do that? That was obviously a joke. Nailing aluminum foil to the crawl space? Come on. Be sure to support the show. Patreon.com/phonelosers or phonelosers.org/cactus. Hurry up and sponsor it ASAP so you get one of these amazing coins that I'm going to have sent to me in a few weeks. Get them while they last. I'm pretty sure I'm going to have plenty left over, though, so don't worry. There'll be some left over. I got a lot of them. What else? I don't know. Visit phonelosers.org. Visit facebook.com/phonelosers, twitter.com/phonelosers. Visit the Prank Call Nation, prankcallnation.com. For other great shows, many of them live, there's usually a show every single day. There hasn't been one today for some reason. I should have just gone on the air, but nope. I did this pre-recorded show instead. Tonight, Laugh Track Matt's going to be on. Laugh Track Matt and Zax, they're going to do the Party Time show. I have no idea when that starts. It seems like it starts earlier and earlier every single week. That show is not on the PCN stream, so you'll need to go into the chat room and just ask where it is, and we'll give you the URL. What is the URL? Let's see. I guess I could just figure it out real quick and tell you what it is. Laugh Track Matt will be at mixler.com/partytimeshow. Be sure you listen to him tonight. Their show is always interesting.
This is the PLA radio show, coming straight out of Roy, New Mexico. So don't touch that dial and don't touch that tone. We'll call you up on your telephone. We'll call you up and pose as your phone company. Inquire about 900 numbers that cost a lot of money. And when you're frustrated and you don't know what to say, we'll inquire politely, does your wife know you're gay? Yeah, you better pick up or we'll hack your voicemail. Tell people to fuck off and go to hell. Yeah, with RBCP and the rest of the gang, calls can get crazy and downright insane. When we visit your Facebook, you'll always get 5 stars. We love your cactus entrees and your glory holes are large and well padded. Yeah, we'll give it away that it's a prank call. We don't give a fuck, not a fuck at all. Yeah, we'll give it away that it's a prank call. We don't give a fuck, not a fuck at all. We'll hack your brain, make you insane. By the time that we're through, you'll be scratching your head, what the fuck did I just do? So lock the doors, flip off the breakers, get on the floor. I've got some blue Gatorade for you to pour. I'd like to bid $5 million on the cactus. Go ahead, hang up on me, there's plenty more of us. We can mob your radio station all damn day. Who the fuck bids on the radio when we've got eBay? Yeah, we'll give it away that it's a prank call. We don't give a fuck, not a fuck at all. Yeah, we'll give it away that it's a prank call. We don't give a fuck, not a fuck at all. God help you if you answer our Craigslist ad. You're so easy to fool that it's really kinda sad. And we can't be held responsible if we make you mad. Can you believe our parents said this was just a fad? Yeah, we're crazy awesome hackers and we're very self-reliant. You ask us why we do this, we say that it's for science. So don't call the cops, don't even bother to sue. At 12 o'clock at midnight, fuck you. Every Monday brings a tear to my eye. Why did Mildred Monday have to go and die? Her sons were so beautiful and so kind. We should call them back just one more time. Yeah, we'll give it away that it's a prank call. We don't give a fuck, not a fuck at all. Yeah, we'll give it away that it's a prank call. We don't give a fuck, not a fuck at all. This is the PLA radio show, coming straight out of Roy, New Mexico. So don't touch that dial and don't touch that tone. We'll call you up on your telephone. That dial tone though.